law that leads to a government becoming a petro state. And there's some other very good analysis of how within petro states, democracy declines. Okay, so let's go back to energy policy. So in this whole development of the oil sands, there was no intention to have an energy policy that ran along with it. Because if you had that, you might want to pay attention to things like energy security. And I remember after I was elected, so I was sitting at the House of Commons committee on refining capacity in Canada. I think I'm very interested in refining capacity in Canada and pipelines and all kinds of things. And I asked one of the experts who was there from one of the large energy oil companies, what would happen in terms of energy security if the OPEC nations had another embargo? What if, for some reason, supply to Ontario, Quebec, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, PEI, Newfoundland, and Labrador, what if it suddenly stopped with the imports from Venezuela, Saudi Arabia, Nigeria, Kazakhstan? What if those stopped? How would Eastern Canada get any product? And the answer was, it'd be no problem at all. As long as we get those pipelines through British Columbia, we'll put super tankers and we'll run it down through the Panama Canal and around Denmark, those Eastern Canadians. You think, okay, well, if you were thinking, again, if you're thinking like a country, that's not what was straight to mind. Okay, so going back to the project of the oil sands, we're now up to just under 2 million barrels of oil a day being produced from the Athabasca region. Now, I use the term 2 million barrels of oil a day because that's a unit of measurement. But I need to back up and say they're not producing oil. And they're not producing crude. Really wish the media would